your wallet, you spill coffee on yourself right before an interview. Today just makes you want to say, oh my God, why me and what's next? Relax and take a deep breath. You're just having a bad day. These types of days, more than most, call for a little self-care. If you're having a bad day, Bestie is here to cheer you up. Why don't you hit subscribe and click the notification bell so you never miss any of our feel-good videos. Tip number one, meditate. This is one of the most important self-care habits around. Meditation is incredibly beneficial in helping to calm the mind and increase clarity and confidence. Meditation also helps you effectively manage your emotions and is linked to combating depression and anxiety. If you meditate consistently, when bad days come along, you will be much better equipped to deal with them. Number two, go for a walk. Walks can be amazing, especially if you're having a bad day. Take a walk to clear your head or even go for a run. You would be surprised at how just a change in scenery can help turn your day around. Go for a walk in the park if you live in a vibrant city like Vancouver, Canada, or New York City. Go ahead, take a stroll down the city streets. After you're done watching this video, of course. Tip number three, journal. Journaling is a very healthy activity that anyone could benefit from. Journaling can help clear your head, help you make important patterns between thoughts and feelings, and a great way to keep track of your goals. Writing can be a wonderful outlet and stress reliever on a bad day. Number four, clean out your social media. Social media is as entertaining as it is draining sometimes. If you're having a bad day, cleaning your social media feeds could be a great way to guard against toxic content. Try following more inspirational people on social media. Their feeds are usually more positive, which could be a great boost of positivity on a bad day. Let's face it, we could all use more positivity in the world these days. Tip number five, take a bubble bath. Complete this with a glass of red wine, some relaxing music, and you've got yourself the ultimate de-stressor. Consider purchasing a bath caddy which conveniently stretches over your tub while holding your wine, your favorite book, and maybe even a bowl of chocolate-covered strawberries. Delish! The ultimate indulgence. Tip number six, have a solo dance party. Sometimes it takes something random to give you the boost you need to break through your bad day. Just turn on your favorite dance track and dance. This could be a healthy activity for your overall well-being, giving you that healthy rush of endorphins you need on a bad day. So close the door, put on your jammies, turn the music up, and start dancing the night away. Tip number seven, watch funny videos. Bad days don't stand a chance with this one. There are tons of funny videos on YouTube and Instagram that will keep you laughing for hours. So no matter how your day is going, you shouldn't have a problem finding one that makes you chuckle. There has also been a ton of research on the link between laughing and mental health. Even laughing for just a few minutes could make you feel better for hours. Tip number eight, paint outside. Painting can be a very relaxing activity. Especially if it's nice weather, painting outside can be quite exhilarating. One suggestion is to purchase an easel, set it up on your porch, and maybe even turn on some nice music while you paint. You would be surprised at how calming this experience is. You may even add this to your regular routine. Tip number nine, avoid alcohol. A lot of times when we have bad days, the first thing on the agenda is alcohol. We want to head straight home and tackle that bottle of wine. You don't want alcohol to become your go-to when you have bad days, as this gives birth to a very unhealthy habit that could be hard to break. Therefore, if you're looking to escape to a happy hour after a long, hard day at work, try not to make it a habit. Tip number 10, do a legs up yoga pose. Yes, this actually has great health benefits and is a very common yoga practice. Because your heart doesn't have to pump as hard in this position, it is said to give your heart more rest and slows down your heart rate. So if you're having a bad day and you need a way to quickly calm down, this is the perfect solution. Tip number 11, take a nap. Sometimes the best thing you can do for yourself is to have a nap. Being overtired can cause dips in our mood and can sometimes be the cause of why you may be feeling crummy. Or if you feel like you just can't turn this day around, going to bed early and trying again tomorrow might be the best remedy. Plus, getting a jump start on a restful sleep will up your chances of having an awesome day tomorrow. Tip number 12, let the music speak for you. There are days when you just can't find the words to express how you're feeling. If you're feeling like no one understands, then find some music that really speaks to how you're feeling. It could be a sad song to relate to, or it could be something uplifting that may help bring you out of a funk. Tip number 13, practice gratitude. Sometimes a little perspective can go a long way. Your feelings are totally valid, but focusing on what you do have instead of what you don't have might help you to feel better. This can also help you become inspired instead of sad the next time you're faced with adversity. Tip number 14, get some puppy love. We're not talking about that cutie down the street. Well, unless they have four legs and a wet nose. Yeah, we're talking about actual puppies. There's a reason dogs are called man's best friend. You'll have so much fun hanging out with your furry friend, you might forget your troubles, even if it's just for a short while. Tip number 15, unplug. We've touched on social media in the beginning of this video, but sometimes unplugging from tech entirely can do wonders for your headspace. There's nothing that will fuel the fear of missing out, or FOMO, more than social media. Plus, this time away from the screen will give you time to do something creative, or just give you space to focus on yourself for a while. Tip number 16, clean. We're not necessarily taking a page from Marie Kondo, but decluttering your mind can sometimes start with decluttering your home. You don't have to get rid of all your possessions, but cleaning up your room or organizing your space will have a surprising effect on your mood. Plus, when you're ready to get back at it, you'll have an organized space to start. Tip number 17, get fancy. All dressed up and no place to go? Sounds perfect. Self-care can sometimes mean actual care to your outer self. Spend an hour moisturizing your face. Put on one of your favorite outfits that makes you feel amazing. Get a new haircut. Even if you don't plan on leaving the house, taking the opportunity to focus on you and do something that'll make you feel good, at least on the outside, isn't a bad idea. Who knows, once you're all spruced up, maybe you'll want to call some friends and hit the town. Tip number 18, get in the kitchen. Doesn't matter if you're a great baker, chef, or an amateur. Cooking is a fun way to de-stress, and it can be fun. If you're not a whiz in the kitchen, making something simple can be fun too. It'll take your mind off whatever is bothering you, and if you cook something healthy, you're bound to start feeling better. Our food can have a major impact on our mood. So as tempting as it may be to order another pizza, why not try your hand at cooking something new? Once you try it, you may like it, and now you'll be able to impress your pals with this fancy new dish you can whip up next time company comes over. Do you feel any better now that we've given you all these great tips? Have any of these worked for you in the past? How do you navigate a bad day? Why don't you let your fellow bestie viewers know your own personal tips to help turn a bad day into a better one? Enjoyed this video? Hit the like button and share with your friends. Also, subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching.